Okay, now let's extend this language of conditioning into random variables. We have already defined the conditional probability of event B given A occurs is equal to probability that A intersect B, both event occurs, divided by the probability of A, or we need to have the assumption that this A event has a non-zero probability. Now we can talk about exactly the same thing with the language of a random variable. The key to is to remember that the random variable, let's say x, takes a particular value, a particular realized value, small x. This thing is an event. This corresponds to all of those outcomes for which this random variable is assigned this small x value. Now think of this as that event A. And we'll think of another random variable, y, takes value of small y. Let's just call this event B. Now we just plug in this definition. We say probability that y equals to y. We ignore the parentheses on this one. Just notice this is an event. Condition on x equals to x. This, by definition, is the probability that x equals to x and y equal to y divided by probability of x equals to x. And this, use our distribution notation, is the probability of, is the distribution of this xy joint random variable takes value xy. Think of this as a pair of random variable. Take this pair of values divided by px of x. Again, we need to make assumption that this guy on the denominator is not equal to zero in general. Okay, this defines a new distribution. If we fix the value of x and just change the value of y, this gives us a new distribution of y. We write this as the conditional distribution of random variable y conditioned on x, taking value of y conditioned on this capital X equal to x. This is called the conditional distribution function, and it should easily satisfy sum over all y of y given x of y x equals to 1. So this viewed as a function of y is a valid distribution function. It's sum up to 1 and it's all properly normalized.